There have been a lot of reports over the last months and years about a lot of Nigerians that got scammed buying a property. That's people losing their entire lifetime savings on a property that they bought. It's extremely cruel and very discouraging when you spend your entire lifetime savings on a property and got scammed. But from the reports that we have analyzed so far, we've realized that most people got scammed by discussing or meeting a fake property agent. In this episode of Meet the Property Guy, we'll be sharing the signs on how to identify when you are discussing with a fake property agent or a fake property consultant. And at the end of this video, we want you to share your experience with us. Have you lost funds buying a property here in Nigeria before? Or from the signs and the tips that we shared in this video, have you encountered or experienced something similar with maybe a property agent that you have been discussing or you have discussed with before? So let's delve into the topic. Now, the first biggest sign that I'm going to be explaining here is whenever you are discussing with a property agent or a property consultant here in Nigeria and they are against you involving a lawyer. That is a very, very big red sign. Now, it's not like involving a lawyer in that transaction is a very big deal, but it adds an extra layer of safety and security on that deal. And there are also some instances where the property agent, at least in this case, is also a lawyer. I would advise you have an external lawyer. Don't use a lawyer that a property agent referred to you, or don't use a lawyer that maybe the seller brings to you. Always involve an external lawyer from your own side who is a neutral party on that deal so that they can represent your interest and they can do absolute verification of that property for you. So based on your experience, have there been any property that you were interested in, you were trying to buy, and the party selling or the property agent were against you involving a lawyer? Or is there any property that you are considering to buy right now and you are looking at how you can involve a lawyer on that transaction? You can share your comments with us and let's have your feedback on that. The next biggest sign that I'll be sharing is when a deal seems too good to be true. I've always been an advocate of not buying cheap properties. For example, you want to buy a duplex in Lekki, not Aja, and a property agent is presenting you a detached standalone duplex for 35 million or for 40 million. That's a deal that is too good to be true. I would advise that you don't go for a deal like that. Whenever a property seems too cheap, I would advise you don't buy it. Now, cheap doesn't mean that you are buying a property for 5 million or for 2 million. Cheap is whenever you are buying a property lower than what's selling in that neighborhood. There are a lot of times where I've received requests from prospective buyers about properties they are looking to buy at some very ridiculous amount for a location that they are looking to buy. You see, the more you are looking for a cheap property, the likelihood that you are going to get scammed. So is there any property that you are already discussing with an agent with and you want us to assess that property for you just to ensure that you are buying right and you are not buying something cheap or you don't get scammed? You can also drop a comment on that with us, or you can reach us directly at Meet the Property Guy or our official WhatsApp channel. Then always remember, buying a property is a process. You inspect first, you check the place, ensure that you like the place. Then the next is verification, which is where your lawyer or your surveyor comes in to check the documents, check the deed of contract, and every other title documents that the property sellers they have on that property. Then you now move into payment. Don't pay when you haven't done the first two processes. Don't pay when you haven't inspect. Don't pay when you haven't verified. Then I also advise that you always try to meet the property sellers in person. If it's an individual, if it's a family, if it's a real estate company, meet them, have a meeting with them, know their contact addresses, so that in case there is any issue or any litigation with that property, you can always go back and contact them and ensure that you're also buying from people that have reputation. So from the signs that I've shared in this video, have you come across any of them before? Have you discussed with a property agent and you feel like one of these signs is what the person is actually showing? I want you to drop a comment about that here in this video. And remember, you can be a lifesaver. If you have lost your funds buying a property before, I will be extremely glad for you to share your experience with us. Just tell us how the entire process went and lessons that you learned from that experience, so that someone else can just see your comment and learn from that. So I see many of the property guy on the planet, your property advisor, your property consultant, Rabiu Mustafa. See you next time on Meet the Property Guy.